This video will demonstrate how to activate or publish a page, as well as how to deactivate or unpublish one. Let's review Activate Page first. When you create a new page or make any edits to an existing page, you need to activate the page when you're ready so the changes will go live. Activating a page is a routine task. Activate Page publishes or adds the page to your AEM publish environment where it becomes visible online in a browser. Looking at our current 4-H page in a browser window, we see one child page already created and activated for DPA. Now returning to AEM edit mode, let's create a new child page under 4-H for our annual rabies clinic. We'll click Create Child Page, give the page a good title, choose the appropriate template for 4-H, then click Create. The new page is created and the link to it shows up in the local navigation. Let's add some basic text to this page. I'm going to add a rich text box, edit it. I've copied and now we'll paste some text and I will click OK to save my changes. Going to our browser again, since the rabies page has not yet been activated, it doesn't show in the local navigation. But if we return to AEM and we're done with editing this page, we'll activate it now. The Activate Page notice shows up. And if we return to our browser window and refresh our 4-H page, the rabies clinic link now shows in the local navigation. Let's edit the rabies page again and add a really cute image of a kitten and a puppy, which we've already uploaded to our content finder. Edit the rich text box, click at the top of the box, drag the image over, right align the picture, and we're done, so we'll save OK again. Now, in order for the image to show online, we need to activate the page one more time. Again, we get the notice. We'll return to our browser, and if we visit the rabies clinic page, we see all of the changes that we have made. And that's pretty much for activating page. Now let's explore deactivate page. Deactivate page unpublishes or removes the page from your AEM publish environment so it is no longer visible online, but it is still available for you to edit in AEM. This could be useful if you have pages for events or activities that repeat every year, like our annual rabies clinic, or fundraisers like Vidalia onion sales or ticket sales to Six Flags. This information is important to share online before the event, but may not need to be available online all year long. Deactivate page does not remove the link from your local navigation within the AEM edit environment, so you will still have access to the page to edit in the future. However, it will remove the link in your publish environment, which is what visitors see in a browser, or not see in a browser. Only deleting a page will remove the link from both the local navigation and the publish environment. Let's go ahead and deactivate our rabies clinic page. We'll click Deactivate Page, and we get a warning. Are you sure? We'll click Yes. The Deactivate Page notice pops up. And if we refresh our page while still in edit mode, the rabies clinic link is still available. But if we return to our publish environment and refresh our page, we get a notice that the page has been removed or is no longer available. If we browse back to our main 4-H page and refresh this page, the rabies clinic is no longer listed. Turning to edit mode in AEM, we can edit this page again next year. Click OK to save the changes and activate the page again. One last view in our browser with a refresh, and there's our rabies clinic page for next year. And that's how you can use Deactivate Page. For any questions or further help with AEM, please email caesweb@uga.edu.